Hello everybody out there, I am Dark Frog and I'm here to do my WrestleMania 33 predictions video, which is later on tonight, but I am not alone. I will be challenging Streamer Gaming, who, if you haven't checked him out, I'll leave a description in the bottom. Now for this, we have decided it, yeah, if you lose at the end, you have to do a punishment and I have two to choose from. Then I'm not at the end, so I'm just gonna go for it. I think for the debut pre-show, I think it's gonna be Neville and Austin Aries. I don't know much about Austin. I don't watch the 302. I don't watch that much, but I've said Neville. Neville's gonna retain because you know he's really popular cruiser at this moment. Austin, don't Austin. Don't know much about Austin Aries, so, and he's just started, doesn't he, so, that's just a waste. Then you have the Andre the Giant Battle Royal. Now, me and Streamer have both chose Strowman to win, because, Streamer didn't give us a, he just said Strowman, but, I say Braun, because, in the Royal Rumble, he was a monster. You know, and since Corbin is on there, so, and I'm gonna say, but the Battle Royale is gonna be probably some surprise entries, something like it, like, yeah, maybe 302 later, like James Gallagher, the young brother, might snack some of that. Might put Ty Dillinger in it. And what I would like to say in this one, just might just a small chance. Shinsuke Nakamura, if he comes in the Battle Royale, because there's always someone from NXT. I've seen up the Big Show, Kane, the obvious people. And then when it comes to the main show, the six hours, I'm going to die by the end of this. You've got the Raw Tag Team titles, I think it's the Club, Cesaro and Sheamus, Enzo and Cass. Right, and I found this quite hard, because the Club, they've just became champions last pay-per-view against Cesaro and Sheamus, and then you got Enzo and Cass. Streamer has picked Enzo and Cass to win. I do not agree with that. You know, out of them two, what does Enzo do other than speaking stuff? So I would say Sheamus and Cesaro to retain, because with Mick Foley being fired, he chose that win, so it would be a good way for them to win, to prove that Mick Foley did something right. That's something like that. That goes my that one. And then you've got the SmackDown title, women's title match, which is every woman on the roster. So that's Alexa, Mickey, Carmella, Natalia, Naomi's back, so she'll be in it, and Alexa Bliss. Now, I would like to say, you know, we both chose two. Streamer's picked Mickey or Naomi, the return of Naomi, return on SmackDown. And I picked Mickey to win or Bliss to retain. So you get a choice of two that you want to join in. Then you get Dean Ambrose versus Corbin. Now, we both picked Baron Corbin to win. I picked Corbin because, you know, it'd be a great way to end off a good year. You know, win on the Giant Battle Royal, being in great matches against Ziggler, champions, and he was in the Rumble. He did really well in that Rumble, his first Rumble, and the Elimination Chamber. So, Baron should win at WrestleMania to top it all off. Then I think it's the US title match against Y2J and Owens, and we both picked Y2J. I picked Chris to win, because it'll be a great way to tap off this rivalry, because you know Kevin stabbed Y2J, so Fiyoko should defeat Owens just to prove that he is the better man of them two former friends. I'd like to say, if Kevin goes to the pump up power bomb, pumps him up with the Fiyoko somehow falls back into like a code breaker, that'd be quite good. That'd be quite amusing. Then you have the Raw women's match, which is Bayley, Charlotte, this is Banks, this is Nia Jax. Now, this was quite interesting because Bayley's the champion. She's beaten Charlotte. Banks and Bayley are like friends, and Nia Jax just destroys the new one. Now, Strina said Nia Jax, and I went for Charlotte to retain. Because I was watching the Hall of Fame yesterday, and I remember saying that Ric Flair was at that WrestleMania against Michaels. So it's Charlotte, it'll be a good honor on Charlotte to beat Flair, win the gold, and honor Flair. And you've got Shane McMahon, is it commissioner of SmackDown, so? And he's facing AJ Styles. I wasn't sure of this because AJ was in a match with Jericho last time. I can't remember who won that. Was it Jericho? I'm probably wrong. And Shane lost against The Undertaker. Shane went for AJ, I went for Shane. But Shane just like some sort of crazy like elbow into the ring post, into the announce table, and AJ moves, that's it, so AJ's got that one if that happens. Bamstein with Shane. And you have Rollins, I think it's a extreme street fight, no holds barred against Triple H. And I think I wasn't sure about this at all. Because Seth has a lot to gain, but he's got an injury on his leg. But he's been proving he can beat Triple H with a crutch. And Triple H does that weak funny submission, which is quite funny, but quite at the same time. And then with being Extreme Rules, Triple H could do what he did against Sting and bring people back, like Samoa Joe could get involved. That'd be interesting. Samoa Joe, Kevin Owens could get involved. Someone else. And then, we both picked Seth. And then you have the couples match. You have John and Nikki Bella, and they're facing The Miz and Amelis. I thought you said completely wrong. And Strunas picked John and Nikki, which I would have guessed he would, because you know, yeah, I think he likes John Cena. And I picked The Miz. Now, I picked Miz and Maurice because Cena, you know, he keeps on winning, and people say that Cena is doing another move, and he's planning on proposing to Nikki. So what I'd like to say is, if that happens, and Nikki's supposed to be retiring soon, I think, say Miz and Maurice win, they disappear, and John takes his hat off, holds Nikki by the hand, goes on one and proposes to her, and the whole WrestleMania crowd. Could happen. And then another one I found hard was Taker taking on Reigns. I wasn't sure at all. Shuna said Taker. I have no idea. I'm gonna say Taker. If it's me, his last one, I'm gonna go with the Taker. Then you have Goldberg taking on Lesnar. And we both said Lesnar. And the reason I've said Brock. Goldberg's beating Lesnar once and again in a match. So Lesnar, say Goldberg goes for the spear. Lesnar counters suplex or into an F5. Maybe faster. Randy versus Bray. Cena said Bray. I've said Randy because that would be a great way to end up Randy's Wyatt thing. And maybe Luke might get involved. Then me and Shuna have also said things that could happen. Like Shuna said, what did he say? I can't remember. So now what I like to say, Jordan and Ambrose and Corbin are winning. Ambrose goes to the D's. Corbin pushes, Ambrose does his spin up the ropes, but other than going for that close, then Corbin dodges into the end of nails. 1, 2, 3. Maybe? The other thing I'd like to say during the SmackDown's Divas is Eva Marie to return, not to win, just to return. That'd be quite surprising to me. I think that's everything. Yep, that's all matches. No, the only match I won't be sure about if it's SmackDown titles on the line. I don't know. But probably will be, but might be like every team or something. I don't know. That's our predictions. Do you agree with me? Do you agree with me? think it's gonna win. Me, Dark Frog, or Screener Gaming. And Screener, you have two choices of what punishment, if you lose. There's a water balloon, or there's, you have a chance to eat something slash drink, whatever. Like mixing drinks or something, but not anything alcoholic, please. Thank you for watching. Even gonna win. See you later.